Okay, learn how to solve basic equations in 7 minutes. So I don't know if this video is going to be exactly 7 minutes. It might be a little less, probably a little bit more, but if you stick with me, you're definitely going to learn a lot about basic algebraic equations. So hopefully this is going to clear a lot of confusion out that you might be having about this particular subject. If you're new to my channel, hopefully you'll consider subscribing after you check out my teaching, and hopefully that you understand it. But if you enjoy learning from me, I literally have hundreds and hundreds of videos on my YouTube channel. Also, I have a full complete math learning program. I'm going to leave the link in the description of this video if you want to check that out as well. But let's get to this, okay? So let's talk about how do we solve basic equations. Well, before we even start, let's just talk about what it means to solve an equation in general. So let's suppose I have this problem, and all of you probably saw this back in fourth grade. Okay, it was like a box at plus three, and then it's said equals five. Now I said fourth grade, if this is more like first or second grade, okay? So if you could recall back to your early years, you would look at this problem or something like this, and the teacher would say, okay, put the number into the box such that this is true. Okay, so they would say something more or less, put the right number in here to make this work. In other words, what number such that when we plug into this box and we add it to three equals to five? So, you'd sit there and you'd be like, okay, yeah, it's two, right? So, in effect, you basically solve this equation. This is an equation right here. Now, this box is nothing more than something called a variable. It's just a symbol that represents a number. Okay, so I could have wrote this way. All right, so x plus 3 equals 5. So your teacher could have been like, what is the value of x such that value plus 3 equals to 5? Now this is a little bit more abstract. A lot of students, when they're younger, would be like, this right here would confuse them. But these two things are equivalent. This is an algebraic equation. So it's pretty cool that you didn't even know you were doing algebra back in the first or second grade, right? So this is kind of down there in your subconscious. You just got to let it kind of come out. And that's what the whole purpose of this video is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to demonstrate a variety of basic equations. These kind of cover the ones that you really need to know, okay, the techniques. So I'm going to go through it. I don't want to make this too long, but if you want to learn more about this, again, I have tons of videos on my YouTube channel, and then you can check out my full learning program by clicking the link in the description. But let's get to this, okay? So remember, we have these x values, all right? Basically, think of this as a box. So our first problem, okay, I'm going to do the x plus 5 equals 12 and x minus 5 equals 12 because this is kind of the same flavor of problems. This one's plus 5, this is negative 5, same equation, but these are the differences, right? So believe me, I picked these particular type of problems we're going to cover. Matter of fact, let me just show you what we're going to be doing here. Okay, so if you understand these variety of basic equations, you'll understand the foundations of like solving equations in algebra, the very beginning foundations. You got to get this down before you can master other stuff. So let's just take this guy right here. Now I want you to pretend that this x here was just a box, okay? Just for one quick example. So this is a box plus 5 equals 12. Or maybe I could phrase this as what number plus 5 is 12? And you're thinking to yourself, you're like, I think it's 7. And you would be correct, right? And your brain is figuring it out and everything else. But how do we do this in algebra? What kind of techniques do we use? Well, this is what we do, okay? To solve this basic equation, I want to get x by itself. I want to get x is equal to. So if I get the equation where it's x is equal to one side, and it's usually the left-hand side of the equation, and I get this down to just one number, this is the answer. So x is equal to this number, that's the answer. Or it's basically saying, here's our box. What's the number that we're supposed to put in the box? That's what x is equal to. So we want to get x is equal to itself on one side of the equation. So here, I'm like, okay, well, I almost have x is equal to, but I have this plus 5, okay? You're like, well, what can I do there? I got x plus 5 is equal to 12. I want to get rid of that 5. I said, if I didn't have that 5, I just got rid of that, I would have x and just equal 2, right? I would have this guy and this guy. So not a problem, okay? This is what's really cool about algebra. So I have this plus 5. Well, how do I get rid of a plus 5? How about we just subtract it? We'll just get rid of it. Like, hey, I don't like you. Let's just get rid of you. Minus 5, right? So instead of x plus 5, we can subtract a 5. And notice how I'm working. I'm kind of doing this in the column format. Again, I don't want to turn this into a complete full lesson, but spend a little bit more time on this first one, and then we'll kind of speed up through the rest of these examples. Okay. Here's the deal. In algebra, okay, whatever you do to one side of the equation, you have to do to the other side. It's very much or exactly like a teeter-totter. So an equation is in balance. You know what a teeter-totter is? Some of you out there, well, in the day of video games, right? Here we are, two people, maybe some of you guys don't know, and you're going back and forth, up and down, and I don't even know if they have these in playgrounds, but if you find one, get on them because they're really cool. They're really fun. Okay. But you gotta be careful you get on with one because if you get on with someone who's heavier than you're gonna fly off on one side, right? But let's just talk about that. Let's say you get on the teeter-totter, boom, it goes like this, and you weigh 100 pounds. Okay, let's say you're a kid or whatever, teenager. Well, to balance this out again, you need someone on this side. That's 100 pounds and it gets back in balance. So what's the point here? Well, the point is to stay in balance, and equations are balanced. It's one thing that's equal to another thing. It's like 100 pounds, it's equal to another 100 pounds, okay? It's in balance. So if I just took away 5 pounds from this left-hand side of the teeter-totter, and you kind of think of it that way, well, I gotta take away 5 pounds on the right-hand side to keep this in balance. So this is the key to solving equations. Whatever you do to one side of the equation, you can do to the other side of the equation. You can do anything you want, okay? You're not going to break the equation as long as you do things equally to both sides. Okay, now I've very specifically subtracted 5 from both sides of the equations because when I do that, and by the way, you want to kind of think in this manner. We're going to add down like in columns. So it's going to be x plus nothing is just x, and then plus 5 plus a negative 5, okay, or 5 minus 5 is 0. I'm left with this equal sign, and then we have 12 plus a negative 5, or 12 minus 5 is 7. So I have x is equal to 7. All right, and that is basically, that's the number such that if I put it into this box, okay, 7, that will make this entire statement or equation true. That's the essence of solving equations, okay? All right, so I'll let that kind of soak in here for a second. Now I'm going to kind of pick up the speed and go through the rest of these examples again. If you're not quite sure what I'm doing, you need to kind of, do a little bit more extensive instruction on this. But if you're understanding the essence of what I'm going to do here, then you're going to be, pretty solid in basic algebra equations. Okay, so I'm going to pick up the speed a bit. So I have x minus 5 is equal to 12. Well, again, I want to get x by itself. I got this negative 5 hanging out here. This time I'm going to add 5 to both sides of the equation because adding a 5 will remove this 5 here, okay? I'm like, if I add a 5, this goes away and I'm just left with x on this side, right? I add down, these 5s go away and I'm left with x is equal to. That's the objective. And then here I got 17, and that's the equation. Okay, so these are basically one type of basic equation. These are what we call one-step equations because they only require one step to solve. Okay, now let's take a look at this situation. 2x equals 6. This in algebra means 2 times x. So this would be 2 times some number. You kind of think of it using our box example. 2 times what number box, right, is equal to 6? If I just ask you, hey, I got 6, 2 times what makes 6? You would just say, oh, that's 3. So again, same idea here. We want to get x by itself. So when we have a number in front of an x, this means multiplication, we want to do the reverse of multiplication, okay? And that is division. And let me just make this point over here. Here, I use subtraction, which was the reverse or the opposite of addition. When I had subtraction, I did the opposite of that. That's addition. This is multiplication, so I want to do the opposite of multiplication, which is Division. So I'm going to divide both sides by 2. Remember, I got to do both sides. So when I do this, I get x is equal to 3, and that's the solution. Okay? So obviously, when you study this a little bit more formally, you understand these particular functions and the reverse, their opposite functions. Okay? This is a multiplication. Division undoes multiplication. All right, now let's take a look at another example here with a negative number. All right, no big deal. Here, what do you think I'm going to do? Well, I want to get x by myself, by itself, right? So here, x is by itself on the left-hand side. Same thing. So I have a negative 2. I want to get rid of that. So I'm going to divide both sides of the equation by negative 2. And I get x is equal to negative 3. So hopefully, you're at the stage where you understand positive and negative numbers. If you struggle with that, I want to check out a YouTube video that I did about 10 years ago as a time of this particular video. It's approaching, I think, close to like 900,000 views. So check that out. I know a lot of people cleared up the rules with positive and negative numbers. You need to really understand it when you're working with basic equations. Okay, so now let's go down to the last kind of variety of one-step basic equations. So here we have fractions. Now, you can kind of think of this as division. 2/3 x equals 5. I could write this as this: 2x over 3 equals 5. Okay. Now we're going to do this problem over here, but let me just show you how this what an equivalent way to write this problem. It could be negative 1x over 4. So we have a division scenario going on. So remember, with division, I mean, so with multiplication, we had 2x. We use division to help us solve. Now this, I want you to think as division when you see a fraction. So we're going to use multiplication to help us solve. So this is really easy. So again, we want to get x by itself. So what can I do to 2/3 to just get an x or 1x? Well, how about if I just multiplied this side by 3/2? Okay, because 3/2, if I just flip this number upside down, I have 2/3. If I flip it upside down, when you multiply fractions, 3/2 times 2/3, you get 6 over 6, in this case 1. So anytime you multiply a fraction by itself flipped upside down, we call that the reciprocal. So you have a fraction and you multiply it by its reciprocal, you always get 1. All right, so 1x is the same thing as x. So you're like, oh, okay, so all these x's over here are really 1x. All right, so but again, what did I do? Well, I multiplied this side of the equation by a 3/2. So I got to do the same thing over here. All right. So when I multiply 5 times 3/2, that's 5 over 1, I'm going to get what? That's 15/2. And there's no need to kind of take 2 and divide it into 15. That's it. Okay. All right. So if this is making sense to you, then we can finish up this last problem pretty straightforward. So I have the negative 1/4. Don't worry about the negative sign. Okay, we have to multiply by the negative reciprocal. So that's negative 4 over 1. So I have to multiply this side by negative 4 over 1. So negative 4 over 1 times negative 1/4 will be a positive 1x. And over here, we'll get 3 times negative 4 over 1, or 3 just times negative 4 is negative 12. And we're done. So that's basically it. I'm pretty sure I went over 7 minutes. I hope you're not disappointed. But when I make these titles, usually I make so many YouTube videos, and hopefully you'll consider subscribing. That I'm generally pretty good, but you know what? I continue on if I think that I'm, saying something that's gonna make you understand the stuff. My background is I'm a math teacher, teach middle school math, high school math, and beyond, teaching many, many, many years. So believe what I'm telling you. I'm really trying to focus you in on the best practices for learning math. So again, I hope you consider becoming a subscriber. I'm posting almost every day various YouTube videos from basic math to advanced math. If you check out my learning program by looking at the link in the description of this video, you'll be able to see my wide variety of math course options. So whether you're in middle school, high school, college, or studying for various types of tests, my program will be able to help you out. And if you like this video, definitely appreciate a thumbs up and leave me some feedback. What do you think? Are you struggling in algebra? Is this kind of new? Were you taught this in a different way? Because it's this basic equation stuff, one step equations, can be kind of taught in a different kind of stylistic approach. And as long as you understand it, I'm not judging it one approach from another. But for me, when I teach this to students over a long period of time, they tend to understand this way the best. But with that being said, I definitely wish you all the best in math. Thank you for your time, and have a great day.